Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Today the word is about our harvest is crying out.
Yeah.
In the book of James describes the powerful end time and a prophetic event about the vengeance of our Lord in the last days. In the prophecy of James, his vengeance is specifically directed against economic injustice, and it is the first time in the New Testament that God refers to himself with the Hebrew name, the Lord of Sabaoth. If you read in James, someone can read James 5 verse 1 to 4.
James 5, 1 to 4, right?
Yes.
1 to 4. Come now, you rich, weep and howl for your miseries that are coming upon you. Your riches are corrupted and your garments are moth-eaten. Your gold and silver are corroded, and their corruption will be a witness against you and will eat your flesh like fire.
Now verse 4 says, look, the wages you have withheld from the laborers. Now how do we held the wages of the laborers? Sometimes we don't pay them off in a fraudulently way, and you who have moved your fields are crying out. When the laborers work for us, you know, and they really put in their hard efforts, and we do not pay them back for any, whatever reason, we do not pay them work out, they are crying out. That is against us for vengeance. And the cries of the harvesters comes to the ears of the Lord of Sabaoth. Now, who is the Lord of Sabaoth?
It's God, Yahweh.
Yes, and who is the host? The host is the angel. They are the angels of the Lord. Now we have to remember there are two cries coming up to God here. One from the wages, crying to get into the hands of the rightful owner, and the other from the laborers, waiting to receive their overdue wages. What are they crying out for? The vengeance of the Lord. Many of us are in the body of Christ, have sown financial seed into the kingdom of God. Just like Pastor said, that if you don't have money to give the offering, you know, take it from me. So we have sown our seed in the kingdom of God, but we have not yet received the harvest. Many of them have been sowing for so many reasons, but they still wait, and Lord, we have not received our harvest.
Yes.
Due to them, remember, we always have to remember that we have sown our seeds. Harvest belongs to you, whoever has sown. But remember, Satan is holding it. Satan is a thief, a deceiver, and so are the spiritual forces under his demonic control. Okay? Satan doesn't want the believers to receive their harvest, because he knows that when they do, their faith in God's law of sowing and reaping will have proof, and they hate testimony. Like Pastor said, please, every Sunday he says, please come and give testimonies. Why? Because when we give testimony, we are praising God, our faith is growing more and more in the Lord, and we come closer. But the Satan does not like testimony. So we have to stand here to give testimony. The more we give testimony, the more we receive our harvest, especially of healing and financial breakthroughs. Miracles are evidence to the unbeliever that faith in Jesus and God's word is able to bring heaven and earth. Sharing the gospel. Whenever we go, we must share the gospel. Eradicating poverty. Feeding the hungry. Whenever we find somebody hungry, we must feed them. And advancing God's kingdom in every nation. Okay, wherever we go, we have to make sure we are preaching. Now for this, what does it take? It takes a lot of money. It's not easy. Like running a church, going out for preaching, everything needs money. That's why in Psalms 35:27, Pastor Kenson, someone read Psalms 35, 27.
May those who delight in my vindication shout for joy and gladness. Yes. May they always say, the Lord be exalted.
Church, every believer, we all have to be very, very, because that's what Psalm 35, 27 says, we all have to be very, very aggressive harvesters. The more we harvest, the more we receive. We must enforce the release of our harvest, not from God, because He has already given it to us, the promises that He's given, but from the kingdom of darkness. This is why Jesus said, and from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and violence taken by force. Matthew 11, 12. Okay, you can read that.
Matthew 11, 12 is coming. And from the days of John the Baptist, now the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent take it by force.
Yes, thank you. Hallelujah. Church, now as we know where our harvest lies and God has spoken how we can achieve, let us all pray, follow His command and stand here to give our testimonies. Okay, so we have to come and give our testimonies, whether whatever financial breakthrough we have received, the healing we have received. Okay, so this is the word for today. I thank